Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today, I'm taking you through a patient of mine, showing you before and afters, and we're going to watch the injection process. So we cleanse the area really well. The submentum area, which the patient's already had treated, we're gonna just touch that up, but you can see we have a nice angle there. And I'll take my red marker for a minute, and I like to mark the areas out when they're subtle. And we have just a little bit of jowling left. We talked about going laterally in many videos, and that's what we're gonna do today. But I mark where the downturn is, where the edge of that mesomental fold is. Mentum means jaw. The jawline is very important. So while I don't use the grid, I do mark the jawline, and our nerve that can change the edge of the mouth comes right up through here, this intersection. And so we're mindful of that, but the patient knows in the areas we're treating, we might injure that nerve. It's always temporary. The other thing we're going to do today is we're going to treat this mesomental fold. And the key here is low dose, correct other areas first, and then soften this area. So we have our marking here, and we're going to treat a little bit lower today. So I want to mark here, but I am going to treat this area today. And this is all fine tuning. Let me mark on this side too. This is all fine tuning. And this is the beauty and one of the benefits of Kybella, is that we can use it off grid, and there will be new grids coming out, but we can use it off grid to really fine tune, as opposed to freezing the fat or using other methods down there. We can't really fine tune. And we'll start our injections, and typically for most people it's 0.2 per area, but in this case we've already treated. First one coming here. So the depth is important, and we might not be at 0.2 per each one, because again, we're customizing the treatment in this case. We get swelling, and that swelling seems to create skin tightening. One of the things to talk about is that there can be a platysma band when the fat is gone, but that can then be treated with neuromodulators. And the patient now will already be beginning to get a burn. Now, we'll treat this area below. So, it's each one, and it's lower than 0.2 here. You can go lower dose for this area. It still will create a little bit of a burn. Because there's less fat, we can always come back and fine tune it again. However, there will be some swelling. It'll be less noticeable to the patient here. Now, I'm going to come up to the side here. And the jawline going laterally is very important. So let's define that. And this is the area. One thing some people might do is to pinch the skin, believing that we're elevating the fat tissue off of the nerve. I'm not so certain how much that helps. It's 2 to 5%, and it was done in the studies. So we know what the incidence is. We'll grab another vial. Each one of these syringes is a vial. This is a 32 gauge needle. We want to be very nice to our patients. This area, we want to be very careful. It's low dose. If you haven't done this, you make sure you have the right patient, make sure you have great photographs, but we're reducing the mesomental fold, the downturn of the mouth look, by dropping a little bit in. And we want to stay a little higher than lower. We never want to get rid of anything down here. And if this is a treatment that you don't want to do in your practice, it's very understandable. Removing fat from the face, you want to pick your patient and warn them about what you're doing and some of the possible side effects. But when we're fine tuning, it plays a role. And here, that jawline, the jawline is strong, jawline is associated with beauty. And here, low dose again here, staying high. This area will be swollen. The patient will notice this for up to a couple of weeks, but to observers, just about 3 to 5 days. And then back here, this jawline, when this area is nice and filled, by reducing this fat, we don't have to overfill the cheek area or the temple. And the patient will be getting a little bit of a burn there, and we'll treat submentum. And that's our Kybella treatment, treating the Melo fold, the jawline, the submentum, and a little area that we didn't treat initially.
So that's Kybella. We have many more videos on Kybella. I'd love to hear your comments below on this channel. Also, join us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe to this YouTube channel for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.